Sometimes we all wonder how things come to be. The chain of events. A leads to B, leads to C, leads to Z. Each life is made up of big decisions, and each day is made up of a million little decisions. What shirt to wear, what street to walk on, what to eat for lunch. And all these seemingly inconsequential choices might change your life forever. But who can handle that kind of responsibility? It would paralyze you to think about it. So you have to trust your instinct, what the Greeks might call your character. And you better pray to whatever God you believe in that your character knows what the hell it's doing. I thought I was a man of character, good character, until I made a mistake, a bad one that changed everything. That's why I found myself walking into a lousy LA bar to buy some fentanyl citrate, synthetic heroin, my personal favorite. You see, when I got high, the chain of events disappeared. No past, no future, just the sweet, sticky now. But before I could get home that night with my bag of goodies, something happened. I did a good thing. One good deed that started another chain I wasn't ready for. And a ride I had no business taking.
Your pleasure.
The usual.
He's gonna die!
Call Raymond.
What's Raymond gonna do? He's dying! What you doing, man?
You gonna call 911?
No, man.
Then back off. His lung is punctured. Get me some rum. I need a clean knife and some clean towels. I need a plastic water bottle and a wire hanger. Get a wire hanger and straighten it out. I need some plastic tube, a beer pump or a soda pump. Got me about 3 feet of that. Run the wire hanger through it. Give me some tape, like 3 or 4 pieces of tape. Now get them up on the table.
Go round it up now.
Lift them up. Turn the music down.
Off.
Up. Get those towels. Pressure right here. Just hold it hard. Give me that. Tight. Put it hard. Give me the knife. Lighter. Sterilize that. You got it? All right, if anybody's squeamish, look away. Now hold him tight. He's gonna jump. Hold him! Run some of the wire through the front of the tubing, like 3 inches, and give it to me. Perfect. Okay, now pull the wire out. Pull it out. Okay, give me some tape.
Thank you.
Get the other end of the tubing and put it in the water bottle. Get some tape and make it airtight around the opening. You with me? You got it?
Yeah.
All right.
Squeeze the bottle first. Try to make it as airtight as you can.
Okay, hold it low. Now release the bottle. Release it. He'll live, but you better get him to a hospital now. Obviously, I'd seen a lot of awful things done to the human body. I mean, I'd seen the results, but I'd never actually seen shots fired before, not at a man, not 2 feet from me. It didn't scare me as much as I thought it might, though. Maybe because I knew I could repair the damage, undo what had been done. I guess I should have felt better after saving that man's life, but I didn't. It just made me miss more what I once was. Like a prisoner getting one day out in the sun just made the prison seem that much more dismal. On the way home, I said, tonight I will not get high. I might just as well have said, tonight I will not breathe. Sometimes I feel like I'm just tuning up a Pinto.
Everyone should be such a good mechanic.
When I pray to God, I don't ask him to eradicate disease. I pray that he sends me something that I haven't seen.
I'm half kidding.
Well, Phil, I've been up for 28 hours.
There's no one else now. It's you and Owen.
Tell him to continue prepping and I'll be down. See if we can save this young lady's life.
Everything Copacabana, Dr. Sands?
Yes, it is, Dr. Frankenstein.
Frankenstein.
If I forget to do anything, you just let me know. Scalpel. Pick up some meds.
Careful those ducks there, doctor.
No kidding, careful those ducks. Where'd you get your diploma, Granada? Will you give me some space here, portal cannula?
Whatever you need, Eugene.
Ah, Christ, Fran.
Eugene, is there a problem?
No, there's not a problem.
Come on, Fran.
Just give me the clamp.
How you doing?
Why is everybody worrying about me? Let's worry about the patient. Will you wipe my glasses, please?
How you doing? Are you okay? You okay?
Some umbilical tape, please. Hurry. Hurry up.
Tie it off.
Hurry up.
Shit! I lost the portal vein.
Run! Give us some suction here. Help me!
She's in deep fib.
No, no. Let me finish. I can save
her.
Come
on! Get out of the way.
Shit!
Ready. Move it!
Oh, God. I'm sorry.
What's up with him?
He's all fucked up, isn't he?
with a proper tin geezer, you know what I mean? Like a proper game where the ball is round. What I don't understand about American football is the huddle. Whisper, whisper, whisper. What the hell is all that about, man?
Look, man, they're not talking about their mothers. They're making a strategy.
But you can't hear them at the back of the stadium, can you?
Hey, then everybody would know what the fuck is going on.
Oh, morning, mate. Just chill out, relax, all right? I'll be with you in a sec.
I don't understand that rugby shit, man.
Who are you?
It looks just like a football. They throw it up in the air, they all run for it and smash into each other, man. It's childish.
I'm bleeding Americans. You think you're so great.
Life is all a matter of perspective. You really learn that as a doctor. A man with gangrene thinks he's lucky if he only loses a finger and not an arm. So if your life was going along well and you found yourself walking with two guys that look like Metallica rejects, you might think it was a bad day.
Mr. Blossom will be with you in a minute.
On the other hand, if your life was in the toilet and you had a nasty fentanyl citrate hangover, you could say, what the hell? I am at the beach.
Gene Sands.
How do you know my name?
Took an interest.
I'm sorry, you are?
Oh, I'm sorry. Raymond Blossom.
You gonna hurt me?
Are you asking because you're afraid or because you want me to?
I'm just trying to plan my day.
Oh, man, listen, if I'm interfering with your plans, please forgive me. It's just I was so knocked out by what you did last night. I said, I gotta meet this guy. That's it. That's all there is to it. Medical science amazes me.
Is kidnapping the only way you can make new friends?
Well, you know. Hey, why don't you stick around for a little while?
Nah, I should really be getting home.
Hungry?
No, I'm not.
Yeah?
What do you want from me?
Nothing, man. You know, just hang out. Have a little lunch. That's it. How's your pill stash over there, Don?
Fine.
All right, well, if you start to get low, you sing out.
You want to be my new drug dealer?
Hello? Say hello to Tammy. You know everybody else. Hey, Eugene, have you ever thought about the idea that everything that happens, every action, causes a reaction? I mean, no matter how far away or obscure, butterfly flaps his wings in Tibet, car gets a flat in Toronto, guy gets a blowjob in Bangkok. All connected, all subject to the linkages of cause and effect, even if comprehensible only in retrospect. Claire, look who's here.
Barroom doctor.
Hey, baby.
Here.
What's this?
It's $10,000.
For what?
For stepping into a fray, my friend, and using your considerable medical skill to save one of my special friends. Oh, man, a fucking plastic bottle and a tube and fucking incredible, man. And Claire was very impressed.
Well, she was a big help.
Was she?
She's very helpful.
It's been nice to actually meet you, Doctor.
It's been nice to actually meet you, too.
Hey, Doc. You like basketball?
Yeah.
Would you like to go to a Laker game with us tonight?
I can't take no for an answer, Doc.
Where are the seats?
Come on. Take it to the hole.
Baby, I love it when you talk dirty.
Come on.
There they are, right down there in front.
The hippie in the middle, that's Raymond Blossom. He's a big counterfeiter, moves anything from designer clothes, software, CDs, videos, whatever. Those Russian guys, they're his clients. Now, these guys are straight out insane. They think they're still shooting up Stalingrad. Anyway, Blossom, he's moving up. Enter the Chinese. But what I don't know is who the new asshole is. I mean, how many assholes does one guy need?
Come on! Come on, pass, pass, pass!
Die for it!
I never thanked you for what you did for Isaac. That was really great.
How's he doing?
Oh, he's fine. Raymond's taking care of him.
Is that what Raymond does? He takes care of things?
Yeah. Thank you.
You're welcome.
We've got to talk some business, Raymond. Yeah. You know, Dimitri's not happy.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that, Vlad.
And what about Let's that go. Last batch of vidies you shipped us?
What the hell was that, huh?
And where did you find those fat, ugly guys?
Yeah, you've been watching them? You got a lot of time on your hands there, Vlad.
We need some top quality. We're in the 90s, man.
Could let me have the armrest.
Funny guy. Don't just fuck with Dimitri, okay?
That'd be a great name of a song. Don't fuck with Dimitri.
Hot metal through your skin, get them in, it's known as sin. Been a couple of corners, then be off up in the wind. I track down more victims than low-jack systems. Been pointing your position, then attack you when you're slipping off about a pound. Nigga, going left to even try to fade. Got your chaos playing with death, cause when I grip, you slept. Now you forever gon' sleep. Be meditated, execution style. Three black guns pointed at you.
Bring us a bottle.
I get this one.
What do you think of the club? Just had it decorated, man.
This is modern if you're from Bulgaria. Nothing like Bulgaria, man. Over here. Sit down.
Relax, Vlad. We're just kidding around.
Am I laughing?
Come on, come on. It's all right.
Okay, Raymond.
Do you want to dance?
Okay.
Nancy Sinatra.
Yeah, nice leg. You want to know what I think?
I think you've been cutting us out of the hoop, Raymond.
You've been screwing us over.
Hey, Dimitri knows you've been dealing with a Chinaman.
Come on, man, you think we're stupid?
How come we just can't go out anymore and have a nice time?
Dimitri's getting angry, man.
Yeah.
Can't cover up your ass anymore, Raymond.
Ray, we heard you had some kind of trouble in one of your clubs, huh?
Yeah. Don't worry, we took care of it.
I don't know what I'm doing here.
You're dancing.
That's a matter of opinion.
Yeah. This is not a negotiation, you understand?
You want to cut us off? Dump us in the lurch or what?
It's in the ditch. The expression is in the ditch.
I don't care about any fucking expression. You got it?
This is the way we do things in the West. Welcome to the free world.
Fuck, motherfucker, free world.
Okay, Andre. Fuck the free world.
Yeah, and fuck you.
No, fuck you.
No, fuck you.
Fuck you, bitch.
Fuck you, motherfucker.
Hey, boys,
fuck.
Boys,
shut the fuck up.
How'd you lose your license?
I was operating on a patient, and the patient died.
Was it your fault?
I was under the influence of narcotics and amphetamines at the time, so yeah, you could say it was my fault.
How long ago was it?
10 months, 5 days. What time is it now?
So how come you're still stoned?
Yeah, we'll see who ends up in the ditch, okay?
Okay.
Yeah, we've been to wars before, Raymond.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. Uh-huh. Remember Afghanistan.
Very bohemian.
There's no place like home.
Yeah. Listen, Doc. Anything you ever need, you call me, okay? Anything. I'm a friend. I mean it.
I believe you.
Yeah.
Good night, Claire.
Good night.
Sarah'll check in.
Yep.
Is he all right?
Better than that.
Is he happy?
Extremely fucking happy.
What does that mean, extremely fucking happy?
Nothing, baby, nothing.
What's with the doctor, right?
What do you mean?
And do you like him? Is he your friend?
Has a doctor inflamed you in some way I should be concerned about?
No, I don't like you telling people what we do.
Do you like the doctor, Claire?
No, I don't.
Do you trust him?
No.
Why not?
Because he's damaged.
But we like that in a person.
A friend. Ray genuinely liked me. But why? I'm not sure. Maybe he saw that I didn't judge him. Who was I to judge anybody? All I know is since I met him, I'd been kidnapped, taken to a Laker game, a Bulgarian go-go bar with Russian gangsters, and danced with Ray's beautiful girlfriend, Claire. Well, at least I wasn't bored.
Hello, Dmitry, это я. Да, да, конечно, я внутри собираю подарки. Хорошо, не беспокойся. Реймонд не подобен этому нудному запьяцу. Понял. Давай, ребята, поехали!
Get us to a new hotel and bring me somebody to talk to.
I want to talk to you, man!
You want to be out!
You weren't supposed to fucking shoot him, man.
Pointless rolling on bleeding sand, didn't it?
I'm really happy to see you. I finally found something I can do for you.
What's that?
I can make you a doctor again.
What, do you got a magic wand?
No. But I have a surprise.
Hey. Hey, you guys. This is the doctor.
Hey, Doc.
What is it?
Gunshot wound to the abdomen. He's in hypovolemic shock. I'm running saline with a splash of morphine wide open. You want me to drape him?
Hell yeah.
Get him to a hospital.
Hey, wait, Eugene, hey, talk to me.
What happens if you take that man to a hospital? He gets arrested? He gets deported?
Oh, he's on parole. He goes back to prison.
Well, maybe that's where he belongs.
He doesn't deserve to go back to prison. He's not a bad guy. He just had a little trouble with the American way of doing things, like you.
I am not a doctor. I no longer have a license to practice medicine. If I practice medicine, I go to jail.
I'm giving you license. Eugene, listen to me. I need you to work with me here. I am giving you a chance to do some good here.
What would you do if I wasn't here?
Me? I'd probably have to let him die.
Don't you dare put that responsibility on me.
I won't. I will take full responsibility. But you are a surgeon. Now, a man lies in mortal need of your skill. You can either do what you did the other night in the nightclub, or you can let him die.
If I don't like what I say, he goes to hospital.
You got it.
You see that bleeder?
I should have been a doctor. I'd have been a great doctor.
Got it.
Okay, let's get a sponge in here. Look at the damage to the diaphragm.
Mmm.
Retractor.
Wow. Hey,
okay. Do we have any Gore-Tex or mesh?
Yes.
Yeah?
You're doing great.
Anybody lose a button?
Damn. How'd that get there?
Bullet fired from a distance of, say, 10 or 15 feet is gonna enter into the body and carry all bits of debris, hair, and skin. We got broad-spectrum antibiotics?
Oh, we are a full-service store, Doc.
Well, we should start them. There's all sorts of nastiness in here.
Hey,
whoa, whoa, keep them under.
Oh, shit.
Sorry, Doc.
Yeah. Ray?
Huh?
I need you to do something for me.
Yeah, what?
You ready to do it?
Yeah.
I need you to get me some coffee.
Sure.
It's a choice that's been offered to many men. Be a slave in heaven or a star in hell. Of course I knew this was wrong, but I had been a surgeon, and on a big day that can be like flying an F-14, only you are the pilot and the plane. I missed that. And hell does not always look like hell. On a good day, it can look a lot like L.A.
Thirsty.
Anesthesia dries you out. You know, I remember from when I had my wisdom teeth pulled. I drank a gallon of water when I woke up. How do you feel?
Bad.
Yeah?
What do you care?
I just saved your life. I went to considerable expense to save your life. Doesn't that indicate some kind of genuine concern?
I think you want to know where we put the merchandise.
Oh, I can't believe you're worrying about merchandise right now.
You're not.
I'm not the one who was just on the other side, Vlad. You died. I had my eye glued to the monitor. You went flatline. Now, you've come back from the dead. You have miraculously been given a second chance to live. And all you're worried about is merchandise. Vlad, think about it. You are alive. Just think about that for half a minute. I want you to just let everything go. Just let it go. Good. Now, do you want to continue living?
Yeah.
Then tell me where my fucking merchandise is.
Phoenix.
Phoenix. Mm. Yeah, where in Phoenix?
A warehouse. Airport Road.
Jimmy's warehouse?
Yeah.
And you're telling the truth, Vlad. Thank you.
He's doing very well.
I should really check up on him later this afternoon.
Great, yeah, yeah, we'll do that. He's got a 24-hour nurse.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
There's your fee right there, $10,000.
Ray, I didn't do it for the money.
Oh, shit.
That guy's gonna take my place. A younger man. Days had passed since I'd sewn Vladimir back together, and this time not a single hour had slipped by that I didn't think about how much I missed being a doctor. I'd gone from hoping Ray wouldn't call, to wondering if he might, to wishing he would, and then he did. He said he had a little day trip planned and that he had another little surprise for me. I said, sure, what the hell? How bad could that be?
Buildings, no cars, no people. It's perfect. Ah. How you feeling, Eugene? Good.
Feel all right.
Eugene,
when I say China, what's the first thing that comes to your mind, huh?
Rice.
Seriously, what do you think of when I say China?
Are you thinking of something?
Okay. China. Millions and millions of people. What do they want? They want the American dream, right? The American lifestyle, right? If I want to give it to them. That's what I want. I want to give it to them. I'd the emperor blossom. Right?
So you're going to give China what it wants?
No, not exactly. I mean, I'm going to give them, like, versions of the American dream. You know what I mean? Like Calvin clone, get my drift?
Raymond, be careful.
Careful what, baby?
Just don't talk too much.
Oh, come on. It's Eugene, huh? Oh,
I'm sorry. Is Eugene a full partner now?
He's much outlaw as we are, baby. Aren't you, Eugene? Come on.
Just a replica of Eugene.
You think I'm criminal?
I think you're about as much a criminal as I am a doctor.
Yeah? And you're a very good doctor.
Raymond! Wanted on the blower, mate.
Last.
You must be somebody who's always on the lookout for a new way to fuck up.
What is it about me that you find so objectionable?
Other than the fact that you're a drug addict and the only patients you treat are criminals.
You mean your associates? I'm not a drug addict. I don't take drugs to get high. I take drugs to feel normal, to get level. I regulate my drug intake very precisely.
I'm sorry, that's right. You're a highly trained professional. You should know.
No, actually, you're right the first time. I'm just basically always looking for a new way to fuck up.
You have to do me a favor, Doc. Just one thing for
for me. Somebody's been hurt. I mean, you know, it's just a boy, you know?
I'd driven half the night. It was a nice car, all right, but the radio was shot, so I had a lot of time to think. About Claire, for instance. Either she hated my guts and wanted to get rid of me, or she really liked me and wanted to get rid of me. Anyhow, wondering about Claire stopped me worrying about what I'd find on this house call. Who was it that said when a doctor sees a man, he doesn't see good or evil, only sick or healthy?
Come on.
Good dog. Good dog.
Nice car.
Hey, you're the doc, right?
Yeah.
Is he okay?
He's dead.
Don't give me that shit. Fix him.
He's dead. There's nothing I could do for him.
I say when he's dead.
I'll see what I can do. All right. I'll see what I can do.
Come on. He wasn't a fucking faggot. You don't need those gloves. He doesn't have AIDS.
Just a precaution.
Fuck that. Don't tell my friend you think he's a fag. There you go.
He stabbed.
He wasn't stabbed. His fucking hatchet.
It was last night. It was those fucking Russians, man.
They're not fucking Russians, man. I tell you, every fucking day, they're fucking Estonians.
Estonians, yeah. Guys, he's been dead for hours.
You can fucking join him.
Fine. But there's nothing I can do.
He's dead. We gotta bury him.
Where are we gonna bury him, man?
Bury him in a cemetery. What do you think?
You are such a fucking idiot, man. You can't bury him in a cemetery. You gotta call an undertaker, man. The undertaker's gonna call the cops when he sees him, man. You want the cops on our ass?
What do you suggest we do?
I don't know, man. Who cares? Just ditch him.
Bullshit.
Guys, that's... do you mind if I let you settle
No. Here's what you're gonna do. You're gonna do a skin graft. It's gonna cover up the wound. They'll think he died of a heart attack.
Coroner will do an autopsy. He'll know that he didn't die of a heart attack.
And say he's one, you know, Jews with the hair and the hat and the...
A Jew?
Yeah, you can't do an autopsy on one of them. I saw it on Nile Law.
Yeah, but look at him. He's a fucking myth.
Make him a Jew, man.
What are you talking about?
Change his fucking nose, change his fucking dick, make him a Jew!
Do it! I think you gotta get a hold of yourself.
You can't do that?
No, I cannot do that.
Quack!
Hey, man, I'm sorry. I think you just heard that in.
Get off the bus! Get the fuck off the bus! Get the fuck! Quack, quack, thanks. Quack!
Look at this.
This is not how a doctor lives. No, I mean, this is squalor. I mean, you did go to med school, right?
What, are you going to arrest me for failure to live up to my potential?
Yeah, I want to show you something. Is this good shit? I mean, it looks good. You know what it looks like? It looks to me like 10 years.
What?
Yeah, with your priors, 10 years mandatory. And then there's practicing without a license, another 5, maybe 8, depending, you know? Tax evasion, consorting with known criminals.
What are you trying to tell me?
I'm trying to tell you that you're fucked. Et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Listen, Doc, I understand. No, I do. I'm a cop. I love being a cop. If somebody took my badge away, I don't know what I'd do. So I sympathize. I do. But that doesn't make it right. Now, Raymond Blossom was annoying when he was knocking off Michael Jackson records. But in the last week, I've got a morgue full of dead people here. So I'm sorry for you, but I need this guy.
You want me to get Raymond for you?
Well, I guess I'm not giving you the full picture here.
What is it you want from me?
It's a big fish, little fish kind of thing. See, Raymond is done with the Russians. He's about to get into business with a Chinese national who floods mainland China with stolen U.S. goods and hides behind diplomatic immunity. Now, understandably, the American government is very upset, which means I need you to help me nail them both, you know, Raymond and the Chinese guy. Now, you see, I already have one of Ray's people working for me, and you're the lucky citizen who's going to be my material witness.
No.
No, that's the wrong answer, no. By the way, that work you did on Vlad was really good. It's too bad that Ray shot him 2 hours after you left. Yeah, he got what he wanted from him, and he right through the sutures.
From respected surgeon to mob doctor to FBI snitch, A leads to B leads to C, what you have become. I needed Ray to want to get rid of me. Then I'd be of no use to anybody, and I'd be left alone.
Keep your hands up.
Hey, sit down.
Something the matter?
Armed psychopaths?
Oh, well. Their friend had just been killed. They were a little upset.
They were more than just a little upset. I'm not a pathologist. I don't work on dead people.
Okay. From now on, only in hotels, fully equipped, just the way you want it. No more house calls. Is there anything else we can do for you? Would you like some?
No.
Okay. You know, Eugene, you've got to embrace your criminal self.
Maybe he doesn't have a criminal self.
Well, I would say that whether or not he had one to begin with, events have conspired to give him one now.
It's not my criminal self that I'm worried about.
If you're uncomfortable, why don't you just leave?
So, what the hell happened? The guy had a hatchet in him?
That's not funny, Ray. Where's my 10,000?
Eugene, the guy was dead on arrival.
That's not my problem. I make a house call, I get paid. You hired me, you pay me.
Sure, Eugene, whatever you say. Let's go feed the fish.
Someone to see Mr. Blossom.
I'll be back.
Hey, watch this, Eugene.
Winner take all with these guys.
Raymond Blossom.
tree? The premier himself.
You are not surprised to see me, I hope.
Don't tell me we had an appointment I forgot about.
You forgot, huh? You killed two of my people. I think we can say we have an appointment, huh?
You have a grievance?
Yo, Ray, tell this motherfucker to get this gun out of my face, man.
You have your colleague.
Shut up.
Dimitri.
Shut up. I had enough. The war between us is over.
Come on, where's the backup? I'm not going in there without the backup. Come on.
And now listen to me, Dimitri. This is no way businessmen conduct themselves, you see? This is some leftover gulag trip you're on. You don't have to do this.
Just take it nice and easy.
Hey, shut up. You think you are Superman? Let's see how much pain you can take.
I don't quite follow you, Dimitri.
You don't follow? Follow this. No!
Okay, okay, enough! Enough!
Watch this.
Dimitri! Enough! Ray, we gotta get her to a hospital. We don't fucking... hospital. She'll go to jail. Ray, she could die here. Get to a hospital.
Go to a fucking hospital.
We gotta go to a hospital.
We are not normal people. We don't
just drop
normal.
Us off and I'll take care of it.
No, go to
Cheryl,
hospital. Cheryl,
fuck
right.
Us at the hotel. I can't do it that way. I can't do this at the hotel.
Hold on, man. No, they got every last one of these messages. This is shit, man. Call him. All right, man. No.
I'll help you!
Fix it!
Hold on, David, hold on!
What's going on? Finish this up, man!
What are you doing back there?
This is a nightmare!
Shut the fuck up, all right?
Come on, man!
Doctor, talk to me!
What are you doing?
I'm giving
her
something for pain! All right. Hey, here we go, all right. All right, what are you doing now? How is she? Huh? Hang in there, baby!
Come on.
All right.
Come on, Claire. Oh, Jesus. All right. It's too late, Ray.
What the fuck you mean it's too late?
She's dead.
Get out of the car! What the hell did you do to her? What did you do to her?
Anything to her? She got shot!
Ray, what the hell did you do to her?
She lost too much blood! Ray.
Fuck!
We gotta get rid of the body, fuck. Though, Ray.
Fuck!
Ray.
Fucking hate people! Get the hell in the car!
We got a dead body in the car. We gotta get rid of
it. Yeah, what's your opinion? Just get in the bloody car. Get in there, man. Fucking get real, man.
Mate, just calm down for a minute, right? You gotta sort it.
Otherwise, you're gonna fix shit, right?
You bring the body to the beach.
No, not here.
I did everything I could.
I put the gun down, man. Get in the car.
Oh, I love this. Where are we going?
It's right on the beach. You'll love it.
This is a place Raymond owns?
Hello, old zip.
How long do you think we're gonna stay there?
Not long.
Well, it's not long, like a few days, a week. What do you think?
Listen, Dredd. This is what you might call a fluid situation.
I understand, but we have to dispose of the body.
I think it's best not to anticipate too much. Just take things as they come.
Thank you.
Where's Raymond?
I made him think you were dead.
So you were on the wire for Gage?
Yeah.
Excuse me, where's the nearest hospital?
That's more than a half hour away.
What the hell happened to you?
It's my friend.
Bring him in.
Don't worry. Nothing said.
Susan, can you hand me those forceps from the boiling water over there?
You need a knife, Doc?
Oh, no. This'll be fine. Hey, Jerry, will you do me a favor? Will you take your stethoscope off? Put it on. I want you to put it over her heart. Every time her heart beats, I want you to tap your foot. I need to know what her heart's doing.
Okay, Doc.
Now, be real careful. Such a pretty little thing. I just want a little teeny scar.
Oh, I'll give her a tiny scar. You're not even gonna know I was here. Here it comes.
Ooh. 9mm.
Jerry, either her heart stopped or your foot stopped.
Oh, I'm sorry, Doc.
It's okay.
Gonna be all right?
I believe she's gonna be fine.
I could use another beer.
All I got in the way are clean clothes.
Thanks. And thanks for helping me.
You do what good you can and pass it on. You're welcome to stay, you know.
We actually have to move on, though. But thank you.
Sure is a lot of gloop in there.
You're gonna hurt the resale value.
It's true. Probably have to strip it out for parts.
Actually, I was thinking of trading it in. How's the pain?
It's better.
You should take these. I got two left.
No, thanks.
Claire, they're painkillers. That's actually what they're designed for.
Yeah, I know. Eugene? Thank you.
Run and hide or turn ourselves into the FBI. Don't you hate those little decisions? I took the only option any reasonable person would. I put it on hold.
Where are we?
My family's summer house. When I was a kid, any time a friend of mine got shot, I'd bring him here. Okay. 16 steps. One. There you go. You want me to carry you?
No.
You want to carry me?
Is that you?
The wall of shame.
What if your parents come on?
They won't come on.
Are you sure?
Yeah, well, my father's dead, so.
Sorry.
Yeah, he won't be showing up. And my mom's retired, so she stopped having anything to get away from.
What'd she do?
She was a doctor.
Of course.
Sit down here. Now I get to use the line I always wanted to use in medical school. Take off your clothes and get under the sheets.
Yes, doctor.
Okay. Get some sleep. I'll be back to take a look at you later.
Okay.
All right. Ray, we gotta get rid of the body. She was a big help. She's very helpful.
Maybe he doesn't have a criminal self.
Give her something for the pain. She's dead!
Howdy, caballeros.
What'd he say?
Spanish for cowboy.
All right.
¿Qué pasó, Raymond?
I want to hire a couple of maids.
Oh, I don't know, man.
Long hours.
The surf's up.
Yeah, surf's up, Ray.
As long as there's an ocean, the surf will always be up.
See? You see that? That's the boss. First thing the boss always wants.
His ass.
How's Hawaii sound?
Hawaii?
That sounds good. What do you need?
1 week, maybe two, clean a little house. You watch my back until this thing clears up. And I'll set you up in Hawaii.
Who are the girls?
Don Ho. A regular luau.
Funny, I didn't hear you coughing. If you do quit, how long till you're okay?
3-4 fun-filled days of sweats, dehydration, and panic attacks.
If I crash out, you can wake me up. If you need me, you shouldn't go through this alone. Is that loaded?
I figured if any of the bad guys show up, you could shoot them.
Did you like being a doctor?
It's what I did. Every day. All day long.
singing?
Gage, it's Raymond Blossom.
Do I know you?
As well as you can know someone you have under 24-hour surveillance.
That Raymond Blossom. What do you want?
My girl. I want my girl back.
You gotta be kidding me.
No. Your doctor took my girl. I want her back. I love her. Are you still there?
Yeah. What if she's dead?
Well, call me sentimental, but I still want her back.
Here's what I need. I will provide you with some merchandise to deliver to your Chinese friend. It's the real thing. He analyzes it. The programs are 100% legit. Now, Ray, this is no big bust. You'll be wired. You drop the line, you get your Chinese friend on tape buying, and you leave quietly. You do that. See what we can do for you and your girl.
I'm your man. Feeling?
Fabulous. Don't get up.
I should take a look at
that. No, that's okay. Besides, I don't have 10 grand.
You're not insured?
No. Anyway, you look a lot worse than I do.
I'm actually kind of excited. Mm. You're the first patient I've had in a while who's not a sociopath.
Well, I'm not Snow White, am I?
I don't think any of us are.
Well, at least you used to be something good. And I don't know what I've been. So now I'm probably going to jail with a pretty little hole in my chest, nicely stitched up.
I could ask the FBI for adjoining cells. I am your doctor.
Did you call them?
But we have to.
Yeah. So, must have been great growing up and always knowing what you wanted to be.
Yeah, it was great. It was. But when you come from a long line of doctors, it's not good enough to be a doctor. You have to be the doctor, you know? It wasn't about being a surgeon anymore, it was about me. I mean, when you're a surgeon, people come to you and they say, you can save my life. You can save the life of my child, you know? And they look at you with these eyes full of hope, and you want to do it. You think, if I go to sleep, who's going to save all these people? That's the way God feels, right? I needed help to stay up, though, you know? Start taking drugs. I'm a doctor. I can handle it. Some meth to get up. A little fentanyl citrate to come down. And then one day, I found myself up and down at the same time. And I realized that I wasn't God. I wasn't even an angel. And all those lives I saved didn't add up to the one life that I lost. Well, that's what I've been thinking about anyway. All night.
Well, you saved me.
Thank you for getting shot.
Anytime.
Wow, that's a big fish. Yeah, this is nice. This is very nice. Yeah, I like it a whole lot better than that shithole you were in. Yeah. I mean, you could have a girl back here.
The problem is, even though you get points for calling, you still owe me.
How are you feeling about Raymond these days? Huh? Do you love him? Do you feel attracted to him? You know, attracted to him sexually?
Where do you get off? Oh, jeez.
The fucking see here. What I need from you is to make Raymond believe that you're still in love with him. Then we can end this whole thing.
How long?
Till I say so.
Yeah.
Now, you were dropped off at the emergency room of...
Good Samaritan.
Good Samaritan. And when you regained consciousness, you went right back into his arms. As close as you ever were. Closer. You might want to take a leak before we go. We got a long drive.
I'm not gonna stop at Dairy Queen.
I thought your pill stash might be running a little low, so I got you these. It's your brand, I think.
No, thank you.
Oh, so that's it. Physician, heal thyself.
Outfit.
I picked it out just for you.
They're waiting.
So what happens to you?
I'm a material witness. I get a 5-star vacation in a downtown hotel.
Well, don't do any operations.
No more hotel work for me.
It's been nice to actually meet you, Doctor.
It's been nice to actually meet you, too.
Hi, baby.
Hi, honey.
You look pretty good for someone who was just dead. Let me see.
What?
I need to see where you got shot, Claire. Show me where you got shot.
I'm so sorry, baby.
Before we get settled in, anything you want?
No, just the chocolate, candy, anything with sugar for the next 24 hours.
We got plenty of that here. Anything else? Gage said to get you whatever you want.
I'll take an Uzi.
Relax, you're safe in here with us.
Yeah, I saw your work at Ruby Ridge. Want me to get that for you?
Surprise.
What is it?
It's red silk, your favorite. Happy birthday, Angel.
It's not my birthday.
No, I know it's not your real birthday. But you were dead, and now you're alive. It's a new beginning. It's a new day. Get dressed. We got some business to finish.
One ball count. Collins places one foul back into the seats. One ball, one strike.
You want some Chinese food?
No.
You're gonna get sick eating that. It's not good for you.
This is the greasiest Chinese food I've ever eaten.
What are you doing? You cold?
No, man, I'm putting on my ski mask.
So they don't. We're not fucking there yet, man. Why don't you get a sandwich sign that says, I'm a fucking killer? Huh? Can you be more conspicuous? Give me my mask.
I don't have it.
What?
Well, I told you it was there. I mean, you said get the guns and...
I said get the guns and get the masks. It's two things.
I thought you meant my mask.
You fucking loser.
I'm sorry, Flick.
You didn't bring...
You want to wear mine?
No, I don't want to fucking wear yours. That's ugly. What am I going to do, though?
I don't know. I guess we just kill all of them, man.
You hungry?
No.
You sure?
Yes.
What the hell happened to my fortune cookie?
Don't know, don't care.
Fuck! Perry! Fuck, Perry! Just wait here, honey. Doc!
I'll help you.
Doc!
Don't shoot me.
Doc, right on,
don't
man!
Don't shoot
me. Come on out, man! Come on! Perry got in! Come on, Doc!
Don't shoot.
You gotta help,
don't,
please!
Don't
fix,
shoot. Calm down.
Fix,
I'll help
fix,
you.
Fix
I'll,
his ass.
I'll help you.
Get fucking down there. Fix him. Fix his ass now. Fix him!
I can't work on your friend if you point that thing in my face.
Sorry. Fuck, is he all right? Perry? How are you, honey? Hang in there, baby.
First, we gotta clean the wound. I need some hot water and some towels from the bathroom. Don't light that cigarette. Go get it.
Fuck!
Hurry up!
What are you doing?
Tell me where Ray and Claire are.
I thought you were gonna fix my friend.
Just tell me where they are!
First you fix Perry.
He's dead.
You gonna shoot me? You wouldn't kill me, would you?
No, I won't kill you. But I know where to shoot you so you'll be in diapers for the rest of your life.
Take a look at you, baby. You look pretty good. You know, you and I were a really good team, you know, just like Bonnie and Clyde, a little Sonny and Cher, you know, Captain Tennille.
Just tighten up. You know, anything could happen in the next half hour. All access backstage.
Shall we?
Let's have a good time.
Our boy just passed me. He's heading up.
Hey, you can't park the car there.
I'm a doctor. Watch my car, okay?
This is what it's gonna take to get you back. I had to do this.
No, baby, I'm back. I'm...
Save it for later, huh? You got your adrenaline going. I got mine going. It takes a lot to get my juices flowing, but they're going, they're flowing.
The fuck's he talking about?
This is just the beginning. Let's go to work.
I'm with the FBI. What's your name?
Michael.
You're doing a good job. Look, I just, I need you to stay here and keep your eyes open, okay? Stay cool.
Gage, it's our doctor.
What? Stop him now!
You see, Claire, it's pretty fundamental.
I figured it wasn't the doctor who killed Cyril.
It was you. And then I figured that you and the doctor were together. But you see, none of that really matters anymore because he's dead. I made sure of that.
What's he talking about? The doctor's dead.
Lost control of it, Gage. He killed the agents guarding me, and he tried to kill me.
Damn it, you son of a
bitch! This is not your... Oh, shut up and tell me where they are.
Subject on 12.
God damn it!
Come on, Claire. Just pretend we're gonna go adopt a Chinese baby. Thank you for seeing us. I know how busy you are. Well, I appreciate it. You know, here in the West, the way we like to do business is we like to put a face with a voice.
Come on, Raymond. Just make the deal and we can all go home.
Well, Silicon Valley's greatest hits.
Wait.
The cash.
Let's talk.
I'm sure we can look forward to a long and prosperous relationship.
Some things below have gotten confusing. I'm afraid, sir, I have no idea
what you're talking about.
Confused? I'm not the least bit confused.
I'm sorry. My English is not so good. Please forgive me.
My English is perfect.
Ah!
out of the car. We've been placed.
Oh!
Now you just wait here a second, baby. Just relax, this shouldn't take me more than a moment.
One more detail I have to take care of, Missy.
I just gotta go kill your doctor.
Doctor boy!
What are you gonna shoot me, Doc? That'd be so out of character for you!
Because when are you such a good judge of character?
Come on, put up your dukes! Put them up! Two guys fighting over a girl, you gotta love it!
Shut up, Ray, I'm so sick of listening to your bullshit! Let's go, Claire!
Come on, Doc, come on! Now, where do you think you're going? Hey, get back in the car! Oh, now you're not talking to me?
Relax, Ray. Have a smoke. Wait for your FBI friends. They'll be here soon.
Bucket, I'll have to kill both of you.
The money.
Yeah.
Oh.
How's it look?
Not very good. You got a lot of internal bleeding. Your spleen's probably ruptured.
So if I shoot you?
So if you shoot me, we could both die on this bridge. The chain of events had ended where it began, with me leaning over a patient trying to save a life. Well, Ray got his life in a state correctional facility. Claire, she's trying to get her life back together, but this time she's being very responsible. I made her take out insurance so she can get a really good doctor. Can't be everywhere, you know. I may get my license back, I may not, we'll see. In any case, I guess I learned that if you're in the business of saving lives, you better start with your own. And of course, always call 911.
Love, we'll confess.
buttons. Stand.